हरे कृष्ण
कृष्णा। सो मोस्ट ऑफ यू आर जॉइंड वेरी अर्ली ऑल्सो, थैंक यू सो मच फॉर युवर एंथुजियास्टिक पार्टिसिपेशन. एंड टुडे इज अवर लास्ट सेशन इन अवर कोर्स, भगवद्गीता सिंप्लीफाइड कोर्स सेशन 6. सो वी जस्ट शेयर द स्क्रीन. यू आर एबल टू सी माय स्क्रीन प्रो?
यस प्रभुजी. यस
ओके. सो थैंक यू सो मच फॉर जॉइनिंग एंड ऑल्सो for your enthusiastic questions and participation. It's very much I could see like your interest, your giving time for these sessions. Really, I felt very happy to be with all of you. We are fortunate to be with all of you who are very enthusiastic in know about Bhagavad Gita, learn about Bhagavad Gita. So today we'll just start with this icebreaker, like how we do every day. What is the happiest day in your life? You would like to put in chat or you want to say something? The chat started, I think. Hare Krishna. Anyone can put what is the happiest day in your life?
Can I say? Krishna,
you want to speak? Can I raise hand? Yes. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Hare Angel.
The happiest day in my life is after joining ISKCON. I mean, in the sense, I heard 18 days course, so I got the privilege of knowing more about Krishna.
Thank you so much for
that. That is the starting point. Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you for sharing.
Prabhuji, my name is Ramachandra. Yes, I have an... I worked up to 74 years of my age there. There was no happiness at all in my life. So as Prabhuji said, when once I joined ISKCON in Bangalore in the year 2012, from then I am very, very peaceful and happy to lead my life. And have
Thank you so much, Ram Sensei. Thank you so much.
Because Manjunath called me and asked the profile of the customer, which even amongst this guy.
Yeah.
Abhishek.
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji.
Hare Krishna, Mataji.
Actually, my happiest day is in getting associated with Bhagavad Gita through your excellent guidance.
Hare
Thank
Krishna.
You. Thank you, Prabhuji.
Hare Krishna, Mataji. Yeah. Thank you so much, Mataji, for all your sharings. So many are told their birthdays, many are told about ISKCON. So for the
Sir, my happiest day of life was when I was born, because if I was not born, then this happiness was not last.
Yeah. You are happy that you are born. And also we understood from our sessions, we are born as a human to understand more about who are we and what is our goal of life. Thank you so much for sharing. So we'll continue with our session. Okay. So, and also, as all of you discussed that happiest day, so even for all of us, like we come into touch with understanding about Bhagavad Gita, come in touch of devotees, like that was the moment we also felt so much happy. So with that, we understood the importance of reading Bhagavad Gita, understanding Bhagavad Gita, understanding association. We'll start today with our regular prayers of Mangalacharan. So I'll recite slowly. You can recite after me. ओम अज्ञान तिमिरंदस्य
ओम अज्ञान तिमिरंदस्य
ज्ञानांजना शलाकया
ज्ञानांजना शलाकया
चक्षुर उन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः
तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः
नमः ओम विष्णुपादाय
नमस्ते
सरस्वती देवे
नमस्ते सरस्वती देवे
नमस्ते सरस्वती देवे
गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे
गौरवाणी
प्रचारिणे
विशेषा शून्यवादी
श्रीवासादि गौरभक्तवृंदा
हरे कृष्णा हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे
हरे राम 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 हरे हरे
Hare Krishna. So today, as Akshay Prabhu explained, so we have a lot of things to go ahead. So today, like, I'll just explain how, what will be our discussion and what will be our agenda. First, we'll be seeing something interesting today. Just before starting our session, we'll be seeing, like, we all know that we have got connected to this program. We all of us are daily meeting at this point of time. So, like, we are connected to, as I said, nice congregation temple ISKCON in Kumaraswamy Road, Bangalore. So myself, Sankarshantaya Prabhu, Akshay Prabhu, like, there are 8 languages this session is going on every day. You might already know about this. So all the devotees who are conducting, all are coming towards, we meet every Sunday in our temple. So we want to discuss and show some glimpse of our temple, how we are, and show some activities, what we're doing there. And then we'll just start our today's session. So I'll just show the slides. Let me just go to the slides. Yeah, so quick insight into our activities. We are from ISKCON South Bangalore Temple, so the Center of Excellence for Arts and Culture. So Sundar Roop Shampru is the one who designed, and with devotees, he designed this course as well. He's one of the devotee behind this. And Rosie has so nicely made this PPT. So we'll be seeing a glimpse of our activities, what we're doing here. So ISKCON South Bangalore is one of the temple in Kumaraswamy Road. And actually, as you see that picture over here, to travel in other country, we need a visa permission. Similarly, to go back to Godhead, we need permission and mercy from his pure devotee. So we all know, if you want to go to other country, we need a visa. If you want to go to US, we need a H-1B, B1 visa. Similarly, we need to go to London or we got to go to somewhere, we need visa. So similarly, if you want to go back to Godhead, we need the permission and mercy of his pure devotee of Krishna. So his ambassador of spiritual world, Prabhupada. So that's the thing which we get visa when you come into association of devotees, because devotees will help us to get that. So, and things we would like to see in the temple, like, we want to see the darshan of deities. Like, that's one of the main thing. Like, we have senses. And as I said, we have to engage our senses in the positive things, like in devotional activities, like seeing the deities of Lord and hands to serve the Lord. So like that, if you see, we only go to temple, what are things we like to see? Nice temple infrastructure, nice deities, nice decoration of deities. We could see in this picture, in our temple, we have Jagannath, Baladev, Subhadramai, Sudarshan, Lakshmi Narasimhadev, Gauranitai, and Panchatattva, Tulasi Maharani, you can see, and all the Achar Guru Parampara is there. So, and there is Shaligram Shila also here. So we worship every day, worship goes on for the deities. So, and also we would like to see, like, the kind of different kind of devotees who come to visit from different far places. So they have a nice accommodation for devotees. So that's the things we would like to see in temple. And we would like to also see, like, devotees associating there regularly. So further, we also have, currently the temple is there, but we are to a temple which is between, infrastructure wise, it is but small. We're already started constructing the new temple project, and there will be having 3 deities, like Jagannath Balaji Subhadramai, Sri Radha Krishna, and we'll have Gauranitai also. So Gauranitai is none other than Krishna and Balram. So we'll explain later, like, in detail, who is Gauranitai. And we have guest house, as I explained, nice guest house for devotees who come from far places and stay here, attend some seminars. So like that, we are taking darshan of the Lord. We have separate guest house for them. and there is a place where we can do yoga learning center. So we can sit and discuss discourses, read books, Bhagavad Gita together, recite verses together. And we're planning for constructing like children's and elder care separately. You can see Bal Udyan and ISKCON elderly care separately is there. Planning for Bhaktivedanta auditorium where many people can sit and hear the lecture. So, and also Jagannath Pakshashala where there is a place where devotees sit together and take prasadam together. So nowadays we are in one home, but prasadam we are not taking together food also. So taking food together will maintain a relationship. That's why if you see in our earlier culture also, we used to all come together and take food. If you see earlier, even I could see earlier my parents and whole family sit together and take. Slowly that is going on. So temple preserves the culture. So ISKCON South Bangalore, we all come together, sit and take prasadam happily, discuss about Krishna Katha. So that's the place they're going to construct. Still construction is going on. Almost like next 10 months, the plan to open the phase 2. And offering it as Prabhupada's 125th birth anniversary. So Prabhupada has taken birth in 1896. So this is the 125th year of Prabhupada. So as an offering, we want to give to Prabhupada this temple opening. So that's the plan. So we need all of your prayers who are all here. And it should go on very smoothly. And then completing the phase 2, new temple complex. We have a temple with a lot of interiors. This is the design of the new temple, which is coming up. Altar with internal dome, deities, dresses. We have a paraphernalia rooms for, because if you see the deities are there, Radha, Sisha, Radha, Krishna, Jagannath, Radha, Sumbhadra, Mahi. So for all of them, we need separate room where we have the dresses and paraphernalia for worshipping like ghee lamps and all the chamara, incense, all these things they keep separately in room and they keep ready for worship, deity worship. And we also have deity kitchen where we separately cook for the deities. So devotees make nice bhoga for Lord. And pujari room where pujari can keep his stuff for ready. And there is office areas where people come for meeting so many devotees, maintenance, administration. And there's a gopuram construction at the top. And there are many more seminar halls are there. So for different kinds of things. And there are so many cultural activities also in the temple, like Bharatanatyam training. So there's so many activities are there. So singing. And photos of current status. This is our status currently, ground floor. So currently construction is going on. And there are many other activities we do in temple. Like we go to schools, we preach there, we give Bhagavad Gita to them, and we help them recite verses, one verse in 1 week, and we explain them what is the verse. So you can see it in the Talakattapura Government School, devotees went there. Vankarshan Prabhu, Sachidananda Prabhu, they went there. They doing program since 3 years they're doing. Kumar Swami Leavitt Government School also, we're doing program since 2 years. And also there is a part in temple that is ISKCON Youth Forum, where there is devotees who are at youth age. So they come together and do a lot of preaching programs. Like in many colleges, they have done, many students have attended our programs from in many local colleges in Bangalore, like PESIT, BMS, Dhyanansar College. So many colleges, RNSIT, many people have attended our programs. Many people got benefited. And there is Kirtan, special programs and dramas for them. And the Gita in nutshell course for them, 4-session course, weekly programs for them. And there is a Prerana program. That means people might have connected once and they might have again they left it. They were busy with some other work. For them, it's called Prerana again. We again invite them. Come, we call them who are in touch for a long time. We again call them, invite them again to programs and give them the chance so that they can also participate. So these are the very nice programs about youth programs happening. And also furthermore, as I said, there's preaching going on in Bangalore and also in Suratkal, NIT Suratkal. So I was also part of ISKCON Youth Forum preaching, which I came from Suratkal. So when I was studying in Suratkal, I got introduced to Krishna consciousness there. So, and also very nicely, they do the program. You can see their schedule and discipline of ICC is they have a center where they stay together. And the morning program they do with all together. They have regular training programs, Vaishnava training programs, the regular preaching program. So they go and visit nearby holy places. Like we know in nearby Karnataka, there are so many places are there. Devarayanadurga, Melkote, Srirangapatna. So they go for yatra camps and we get nice engagement. We like to learn so many things from many senior devotees who can train us very nicely. So all these things are happening as a part of ISKCON Youth Forum. And also there is one more thing, interesting thing. jail preaching also happening. So devotees go to jails and preach there. So give them Bhagavad Gita, get a chance to everyone there to read about Bhagavad Gita, distribute prasadam there, do some kirtan. So it's so wonderful. Devotees are like very merciful. They go to even the place where jails also and give to the all the people over there, the mercy of the Lord. So it's a part of temple program. We are doing that. And popular festivals, we all know there are so many festivals happening. So Kartik month, we do Damodar, Mamadar Mast, we will do that Ashoda Damodar Puja. Every day we offer ghee lamp to Lord. So very famous. It's coming soon. So and then Janmashtami, Lord Janmashtami, Lord's appearance. Krishna's appearance, we do Janmashtami. Balram Jayanti, Lord Balram appearance day. Gaur Purnima appearance day, appearance of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Govardhan Puja, well know Krishna lifted Govardhan on the left hand, tip of the left hand. So we do Govardhan Puja in temple. Narasimha Chaturdasi, appearance of Narasimhadev. And we all go for a picnic with the Lord, like kind of there are so many festivals we conduct, go to the nearby place and we do Abhishekam for the Lord, we do nice decoration for the, as a family all, we go together and we cook Bhoga there, offer to Lord and together do the festival there. So most of us are eagerly waiting because of Corona, we could not do so many things, but it was very interesting and very nice engagement for all family going together to a place and celebrating, keeping the Lord as center, doing Abhishekam for the Lord. So very nice things. And also, we all know Ratha Yatra, right? Recently, we are seeing in our channels also Ratha Yatra in Puri. Similarly, in our temple also, we do Jagannath Habba, in that we do Ratha Yatra, which is coming soon. So the festival in which Lord Jagannath comes to see his devotees to give his blessings. So we do Ratha Yatra as a part of temple festivals. And ISKCON South Bangalore initiative in the serving community, like we all know how the COVID-19 has affected so many people, right? So we distributed over 1,000 packets of Sattvic Prasadam to everyone. And most of them received Prasadam who are like very hungry and they don't have any other kind of earning in that point of time. And they got this Prasadam, which is a blessing of the Lord. So you could see the pictures over here. People, devotees over there in temple, they cooked, they offered Prasadam, they packed nicely and then went to the place and they have started distributing Prasadam also. So those are the initiatives from ISKCON South Bangalore. And also serving and into after serving, to serve with compassion, we need deep study of Shastras. So in our temple, we do deep study of Shastric study, understanding more about Bhagavad Gita, Nectar of Instruction, Nectar of Devotion, Isopanishad, Srimad Bhagavatam. So there are so many courses for this. So there are so many programs for children, educating them, Krishna's kingdom. So systematically, we will train youth, systematically train children, systematically understanding about all letters of Bhagavad Gita. So those various aspects of Bhakti are taught in our temple in different programs. So in our temple, we have a variety of this activities where we involve nicely to study Shastras in deep. So there is a lot of kirtans, a lot of music, a lot of dramas also. So enthusiastically people participate in kirtan, dancing, chanting. So blissful Nagar Sankirtan. We go out chanting on the streets so that everyone can hear Hare Krishna Mahamantra. So very nice activities we do as a part of kirtan. And then I would like to welcome all of you to be part of this journey. Serve the Lord, serve the community and purify our life. So that's the main thing. And I would like to heartily welcome all of you to this community from all of us, Akshay Prabhu, myself, Sankarshanta Prabhu, as a team. So we'd like to welcome all of you to this community and be part of our community and part of our journey with all of us. Hare Krishna.
Prabhuji, even not in Bangalore, wherever they are native, they can join there. Everywhere, every state, there is.
Correct. So just a glimpse, like almost we know that what Prabhupada has given us is a roof where whole world can live. So that's the community which Prabhupada has created. So nice. So as a course of interest of time, let's jump to today's session. But hope all of you liked what we are all doing. So let's jump to our today's session. Quick recap of our previous session.
Very glad to hear about your activities.
Thank you so much. Hare Krishna. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Please keep the activities goes on.
Sure. With all your blessings and prayers, definitely.
We must have upliftment always.
Yes, sir. Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you. So, we we discussed about in session 5, right? We discussed about Prakriti, nature. Previous session, what we discussed? Session 4. Session 4, we discussed about karma. Karma in detail, like different types of karma we discussed. Before session 4, session 3, we discussed about we are searching for happiness, difference between animals and human beings, and basic about karma. Correct? And then before that, we discussed about Ishvara. Before that, we discussed about Jiva. That means we discussed Jiva, who are we, Ishvara, who is the Supreme Lord and Controller, and discussed about third session, we discussed about karma in basics and also understanding what is the importance of human form of life. And also we discussed in fourth session about karma in detail, understanding. And fifth session, we discussed about nature, Prakriti. So Prakriti, what is Prakriti? It's a nature, it's a material nature. And Lord says it is my energy. Daivihesha gunamai mamam maya. So it is my energy. And Lord says that. And also we see in this session in different divisions like understanding, we are in material world. That is spiritual world. And spiritual world is a place where we are. But because of our enjoying independent of the Lord, we have come to material world. And material world, we discussed about how the material world is there. And where we are in the 14 planetary systems in one Brahmanda, we are in middle planetary system. It is earth planetary system. And also we discussed Lord has descended from spiritual world to material world. And he descends as avatar and he comes us to attract by his lilas, protect the devotees, establish the dharma again. So and annihilate the demons. Lord comes again and again Lord comes. And also we understood that a very important topic of nature is material nature, how it influences by three modes. And we saw the characteristics of every mode, mode of goodness, mode of passion and mode of ignorance. And we discussed in detail, like in time, eating habits, behavior habits, all we saw in detail, what all those things will be included in every mode. And also we discussed about three kleshas, like how material nature will influence us by three kleshas, which all of us are suffering, like adhyatmic, because of our own body and mind we suffer, adhibhautik, because of other living entities we suffer, adhidaivik, because of natural calamities we suffer. And we discussed in detail about those things. And we understood that we are all playing as in three modes, mode of goodness, mode of passion, mode of ignorance, and also combination of these modes, right? We understood about it. And we also saw how to overcome these three modes. So I explained, we detailly understood it. Like mainly 2 points I'll tell. One point is we understood that Lord clearly saying, Daivihesha gunamai mama maya durattaya, mam evai prapadyante, maya metam tarantite. So mam evai prapadyante. So surrendering unto the Lord and taking shelter of the Lord. Maya metam tarantite. It's very easy to overcome. So and also we, that's the first point, taking shelter of the Lord. But understanding how to take shelter of the Lord is second point. These are about how to do it by taking association of devotees, practicing devotional services like chanting, hearing, reading, and also we saw doing Tulasi Puja, and we discussed about so many other aspects of devotional practices which will really help us in our overcoming these three modes. So especially practicing with full determination, not even with full determination and with full conviction, we practice the devotional life and not disturbed by like external things, and trying to practice under the guidance of seniors. So that's very important. And that's we discussed in overcoming three modes. So, and also there were few, like one question we got in the group. I'll just answer that question apart from the recap, what we discussed, and then we'll go out for today's session. So one question Prabhuji has asked very nicely. So Vijay Prabhu, I think Prabhuji very nicely asked and very attentively he heard. So I was explaining about especially karma, akarma and vikarma. In that we understood about vikarma. Vikarma means which are sinful activities, which are prohibited activities. In that one of the activities, meat eating. So when we spoke about that, Prabhuji was asking that we can take fruits, leaves, we are taking those items. And that also have life, that also has soul. So when we take those things, we'll also get reaction, no? Because we are cutting the fruit, we're cutting the leaves from the plant. That means you are also get reaction. So when I was explaining, I told that when you offer these items to Lord, then you offer it and you honor it, then there is no reaction it. So that was a nice question asked. If I do the same thing for non-veg also, like if I cut a fish, I'll offer it to Lord, then I have it. So I was asking, that is also having soul, no? So if I offer it, the reactions will be taken away, so that we'll be happy. No, because you should hear very carefully here. What Lord says in Bhagavad Gita is 9th chapter, 26th verse. He says, Patram Pushpam Phalam Toyam Yoma Bhakti Prayachate, Tadaham Bhakti Upakrutam, Ashnami Prayatatmanaha. So he tells very clearly, Patram, Pushpam, Phalam, Antoyam. He will not, actually Krishna very clearly explaining that kind of category of what he accepts. And he tells that Patram means leaf, Pushpam means flower, Phalam means fruit. So Toyam means water. So if you offer this with love and devotion, then I will accept it. And it is recommended by Lord that we offer these kind of foodstuffs to Lord, and those only will accept. And foods which are in mode of ignorance should not be offered to Lord Krishna. We should not offer those foods which are in mode of ignorance. Like we discussed yesterday, right? Sorry, about eating meat, fish, eggs. These things should not be offered to Lord. Not even onion, garlic. So because we all know that in South India, there are so many temples. Not in India also, Gaya Vishnu temple is there. We see in every Vishnu temple, you can see there is no way they'll put onion, garlic in prasadam what they're giving. So there is significance. I think yesterday our discussion, but that's how so pure, like foods in mode of ignorance are not offered to Lord Krishna. But why? Reason is, one more understanding of it, second level of understanding. Fruit, leaf, and vegetables, what we're eating, their nervous system is not that much developed compared to the nervous system developed in the animals. The pain what you get cutting an animal is too much than the pain cutting a vegetable or a fruit. So, and also those foodstuffs are like things which are provided by Lord for human beings. And those are not supposed to be taken by human beings. So that's what Lord clearly explains in scriptures also. And people offering meat and to have it, that is very low level of worship. That is recommended in the Kali worship, where people, mode of ignorance worship, people offer kind of blood, flesh to Lord. And that is certain procedure they have to follow. And that is very low level. And then still they have to gradually give it up. So that is very low. So we are understanding, very wise and intelligent person should always follow the process which Lord recommends. As we know, that human form is very rare. So we should not again give a chance. So that's why we should always take foodstuffs which are supposed to be offered to Lord, which are in mode of goodness, and then we should honor it. That is the prasadam. Is the answer clear, Proji? Vijay Prabhu? If you are there. Okay, fine, no problem. So I'll talk to Proji. That's one I want to confirm, because I want to clear all of you that question should be there. We should not offer this kind of foodstuffs to Lord. So with that, we'll continue today's session. So today's session is a very interesting topic, is about Kala. So we all know that's the last topic of five themes of Bhagavad Gita. So last topic is we are discussing about Kala, understanding time, the Vedic concept of what is time. So we all know time is very precious. So and we need to perfect our life within this given time. Time once lost cannot be recovered back. So once Chanakya Pandit, we all know famous Chanakya Pandit, right? There's Chanakya Niti, he explains that Ayushakshana Ekopi Nalabhya Swarna Kotibi. So we cannot exchange one moment of time which is lost with Swarna Koti, means gold, 1 crore gold coins. We cannot exchange with the one moment of Kshana, means one moment of time what we lost. So that value is the time. We all know about it, correct? As the time is very, very valuable. And if one day passes, as the sun rises and sun sets, one day is complete in our life. We'll be coming closer to our death. And we all know how important, we attended earlier sessions, that this form of life is very, very, very rare. And we got an opportunity to understand who are we, what is our relationship with the Lord. And we understood that what I should do so that I can reconnect again with the Supreme Lord. And we learned the process of different devotional practices which we have to do. So with that, we should perfect our life within this given time. Otherwise, what will happen? The time will come. We don't know when we are going to pass away. So we should be very, very careful, and we should carefully utilize our time. So instead of utilizing properly time, if you misutilize it, like again, we discussed like how animals are doing for eating, sleeping, mating, and defending. We are same using the same time again and for those purposes. That means we are not fit for again to take birth as a human being or going to the Lord. So we glide down to different animal planets. So that is very important. So that's why we should be very intelligent to choose the time wisely. When we get free time, we should always take time to understand more in Bhagavad Gita what Lord is saying, and chant Hare Krishna Mahamantra, visit a temple, ask questions when you have, get it answered very clearly, and very nicely practice Bhagavad Gita, what we are reading every day. That is very important. With that, we'll go to next slide. And I was explaining about the sun rising and sun setting. No? Srimad Bhagavatam very nicely explains about this. There's a verse. Ayur harati vaipumsam udyan astam cha yannasau tasyate yakshanonita uttama sloka vartaya. So nice. The translation is, by Prabhupada explained, both by rising and by setting, the sun decreases the duration of life of everyone, except one who utilizes the time by discussing topics of all good personality of Godhead. So, as I said, as sun rise and sunset, one day of life is completed. But except one who utilizes the time by discussing topics of all good personality of Godhead. So now we are all very fortunate. We're discussing about Lord's words, understanding about Lord, right? We are fortunate because we are one who is the exceptional case. So we are utilizing our time to discuss about Lord. So those people, there is no decrease in duration of life, because one day we start learning about Bhagavad Gita. That means one step, we are entering into our eternal life, understanding our eternal life. So that means this chakra of birth, death, again birth, again death. So we can keep on continuing in this cycle of Punarapi Jananam, Punarapi Maranam. We will cut it out and we enter into eternal life. So we're slowly making step towards it. That's why it's exceptional that whoever discuss about the Lord and Lord's pastimes, for them, there is no decrease of duration of life, because we are entering into the eternal life one step by step. And we all know the famous slogan, time and tide, wait for none. So that's why we should be very careful utilizing the time, understanding the importance of time. And we all know the time indicates what we calculate, like we calculate like 24 hours a time, indication of sunrise and sunset. So it should not be utilized uselessly, should be utilized for spiritual values, as we discussed. And also we explained about how we know that we are now the spirit soul. We are not just this body, we are spirit soul in this body, and we are the spirit soul, and we are in this body. And our real identity is always to love and serve the Lord. And that's a real source of happiness. We can easily understand that, because if you see example of, I explained about gross body, subtle body, and soul, correct? Gross body means whatever we can see now currently, my eyes, nose. This is all gross, made up of earth, water, fire, air, and ether. And subtle body means which you cannot see, like mind, intelligence, and false ego. That is what we cannot see. There is one which we cannot see furthermore subtly, that is soul, what we are exactly. So if you want to enjoy, if you want to be happy always, what we should do is, we should always seek some eternal joy through what gives the happiness to soul, which all things we are supposed to do soul. That gives eternal happiness. How, for example, take instead of coconut. It's a very interesting example to understand this. You know coconut, right? Coconut, what will happen? Coconut, there is a top layer, green. Internal, there is brown. And then internal, there is white color, which is Malayar. We call Malayan Karanda. In Telugu, it is kobbari. Like we call, that is the thing which essence we take it. So if you want to enjoy coconut, how will you eat? We'll take the full coconut and just bite it. No, right? we'll get pain. Our teeth will get broken. We have to break first coconut and then second and then go inside. Then only we'll get the real happiness. That similarly, there are layers which we want to enjoy through our senses. We enjoy through our mind and intellectual. We will not be happy. That is not eternal. We have to enjoy through our soul. That is the real happiness. And moment in association of pure devotees. So the time is most valuable, right? We should always seek association of pure devotees of Lord, and we should associate with them. So what will happen? It's explained in scriptures that there is a nice verse that there is a very nice verse which explains that very small fraction of time associating with the pure devotees of Lord will change our life. So we very wonderful, because once we associate with pure devotees, what will happen? By just being with them, by rendering service to them, so they will bestow us with the most wonderful gift, that is bhakti, devotion of Lord, which no one else can give, right? Because they have that. They are pure, they have pure devotees of Lord. So they will bestow that bhakti and will advance in our spiritual life very fastly. So we should utilize our time being an association of pure devotees of Lord, which will really help us to go ahead in our spiritual life. An illusion of time versus best use of favorable time. So illusion of time means, for example, consider this room, I'll make full dark, keep on 55 inch TV and keep watching a movie for a long time, which is no sense of that movie, only doing all kinds of nonsense in the movie. There is no meaning only. So whole day spent for that and wasting our time. It's an illusion only, right? Thinking that you are the hero, you are the heroine, and thinking, and after coming out of the movie also, you will be in that illusion for some time. So instead of that, you can use that best use of favorable time. So you can use that time for doing something which is very helpful for you and helpful for you to be progressing in your spiritual life. Because as I explained, that human form of life is very rare. It is like a very nice example here. You can see I wrote that Benz and tractor. So just to give an example, that there is one person in village. There is a person in village, and that person has a very rich friend. So that friend has come to that person and gave him the gift, Benz car. So he was very happy that he got the very nice costly car. So this person gave him, they all met one day, and he went back. Later, after 2-3 days, he came. This village person, what he's doing, you know, he's taking the Benz car and he's plowing the fields, his agriculture fields. So then this person came and said, hey, why are you using Benz car for plowing the fields? That for you to travel across. So why are you using this so costly car? So you have to use tractor for it, not Benz car. So then I have given you the so costly car. So like that, Lord will also think, Lord has given us the most human form of life, which is like Benz. So we are utilizing it for only other things, which is meant for self-realization, understanding more about the Lord. So if you are not utilizing for that purpose, then better you go with another form of life. Why you want human form of life? The Lord will tell like that. That's very important to utilize it. And with that understanding, very importance of human form of life, we have to understand what is a favorable time for you to do these activities. The most favorable time. So the most favorable time is called Brahma Muhurta. So most of you might have heard this term, Brahma Muhurta. So what is Brahma Muhurta? That's the most favorable time. So if you see, like, whole day starts, the day starts with sunrise. Before sunrise, 1.5 hour before sunrise is called Brahma Muhurta. So that is the time. It is best practice, best favorable time for spiritual practice. So that time, if you see, your mind will be clear. There is no more thoughts and there is no disturbances. So you can sit and focus. So during that time, whatever do an activity, it is considered like writing on the rock. So it will stay forever. So during that time, if you focus and if you do the spiritual practice like chanting, reading and hearing activities, that will be like rock. You will never forget. So we understood, right? Whatever we dwell in, that will become in next life. We dwell in more this point of time, deeper into understanding of Lord and hearing, chanting about Lord. That's what we tell in whole day. So, and also one more example to understand is, we all know, especially in Bangalore or Delhi, we see a lot of traffic, right? The day starts, but early in the morning, 4 or 4:30, you see, it will be empty. Roads will be empty like that. Our mind will be full empty and it will be easy to understand the spiritual things and absorb it so nicely. So very important to practice in this Brahma Muhurta time. It comes around 4:30 to 5. So that's the time, 1.5 hour before the sunrise, you have to wake up and do our practice. So, Hare Krishna, I'd like to answer you this poll. Roji, can you please put the poll? Hope all of you are not sleeping. Please answer this poll. Okay. Well, I think all of you are reading this question. Time is very precious. What is the best time for spiritual practice? Almost 50 answered. Yeah. 51. Yeah. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for attentiveness in the poll. So let's go quickly to the next part of understanding. So we all know that Lord explains in the Bhagavad Gita, Kalasmi Aham. So he says, I am that Kala, as a Lord's come as Kala. So there are two ways Lord explained here. Like, Lord Krishna comes as to take us back home, or he comes as Kala at the time of death. So, like, we understood one example I also told, right? Lord comes to a devotee who is practicing so intensely of devotional life, understanding the importance of his reviving the relationship back and going back to Godhead. Lord comes and personally sends his associates, like Nanda, Sunanda, he sends his associates who can take them to back home, back to Godhead. Or if you are not, then you are just leading our life. The Lord will come as a time of death, and just we will have to take birth again. And again, we have to continue the cycle of all these 84 lakh species. So what we have with us, to not, we have our free will to choose every moment of our life. What will make my next life very nice and go back home, back to Godhead. Not only next life, even you can see Bhagavad Gita tells that in this life also and next life also. So what are we doing? What are we learning as a part of Bhagavad Gita, these sessions? We should help us to lead a proper life in this world also. And after this world also, we are leaving this world after that also. So it is called Ihaloka Padavi, Paraloka Prapti. So not only here, we have to be very nice here also. We have to be out of this also. So we have free will for all these things. We have free will to choose our life accordingly. And definitely Lord will answer our prayers. So that's the time, says Lord. So we have to very patiently, very nicely, very determined way, we have to practice the spiritual life. So definitely the day will come, Lord will come and take us home back to Godhead. So the free will is an important thing. And furthermore, we understand that time is limited as in human form of body. And there are so many ways devotees approach us. They ask us to read Bhagavad Gita. So I also used to think, why devotees stress too much about reading Bhagavad Gita, understanding more about Lord. But we all know the importance of, for example, now we all know that Corona is now attacking everyone us. So we know that there is some medicine which will help us. And we came to know about that medicine. Then we want to give that medicine to all, right? Similarly, we know that we are the human, we are the soul. And the real joy comes when you connect back to Lord. That's the eternal joy. That's the highest benefit which we can give to other living entities. Then what you will do? We will not keep with us. We want to give to others also. So we will give an opportunity to everyone. Please take up. So if you see here in picture also, he's sharing. Please spare some time to read Bhagavad Gita and realize. So I'm too young. I just started my ABCD. Then again, she grown up and saying, I'm sorry, I'm busy with my exams and school. And then next, I'm in love, maybe next time, perhaps after my wedding. And then goes, I'm expecting, so we are having family now. In any case, I'll ask my husband and I'll get back to you. I'm too weak and tired now, after growing child and next becoming old. And I'm too weak and tired now, aches and pains. And then old age passes away, then we dies. So I'm too late. I didn't act, realize my true identity. I wasted my human birth. My colorful life with money, family, and friends is useless at the time of death. So it's the time for you to accept another body. So time of death, Kala has come. And another body, however, there is no guarantee that you will be get a human body because we are not sure whether you get human body or not. So based on our desires in this life. So like that, we tend to keep on postponing this act of understanding more who are we. So that's the problem with all of us. So we should give the time. So all of you have given time. I would like to appreciate all of you. Like we are all coming to the understanding more about us. But generally we tend to postpone the activities of spiritual life, keep on busy with other activities of life. So we should take out the time because opportunity window is limited. We have to utilize that. So very important. And yes, so Vedic concept of time. So what is the time now? This session, this slide clearly shows example of time is in cycle, right? Cycle. So Vedic concept of time is cyclic, eternal and degenerative. So what will happen if you see the cycle, as I explained earlier, there are four yugas. So Satyuga, Treta Yuga, Dwapar Yuga and Kali Yuga, four are there. Okay. So you can see here also four yugas are there. So Satyuga is called golden age. If you see the picture over here, and the Treta Yuga is silver age, Dwapara is bronze, Kali is iron. Iron age because it's the age of quarrel and hypocrisy. People will be always quarreling, always hypocritic. So they talk something in front and they do something on the back. So they're quarreling always. So small things we fight. Simply we fight. So that is Kali Yuga. So that's where we are currently. We are now around 5,000 years in Kali Yuga now. It's the Iron Age, as it's a quarrel of hypocrisy. And how to understand this cycles, okay? If you see this picture so nicely, it was drawn. You can easily understand from this. I'll try to explain. Like you can see here, every yuga, there is a period of time. So Satya Yuga, the period of time is mentioned here, 1,728,000,000 years. So that's the time where people live for like 1 lakh years. Their lifetime is 1 lakh years. because you could see in scriptures also that they have performed meditation for 40,000 years, 50,000 years. The Vishwamitra for 40, 60,000 years, they perform meditation. That is possible in Satyayuga. Treta Yuga, people used to live for 10,000 years, their kind of lifetime. That is about, total is about 1 to 96 million years. And then Dwapara Yuga, people have the lifetime of around 1,000 years they can live. So then coming to Kali Yuga, we have the lifetime of 100 years, we say, but we are not even living for 100 years. So people are coming near to 60 or 70 or 80, like that. People are coming close, very short living. So because of Kali Yuga progressing very fast. We could see very rare ancestors who are there for 100 years or 105 years, but we are getting short. So like that, there is different lifespans. And every Yuga, there is a certain period of time, like Satyayuga, Treta Yuga, Dwapara Yuga, and Kali Yuga. Kali Yuga is for 4,32,000 years. And we are currently now in 5,000 years. So 5,000 years, 100 and 200, like that, exactly, 200, I think. So we are in that. So if you see here, these four Yugas, 4,30,000 years, before that 8,64,000 years, then 1 to 96 million years, and 17 to 8 million years. There are four Yugas. All four, one cycle, okay? One group. That one whole period is called Divya Yuga. You can see here, that is called Divya Yuga. So that is 4,32 million years. And what will happen in this 4,30 million years? If you calculate, if you see here, one day of Brahma equal to 14 manvantaras plus 15 sandhyas. So it is like, if you see here, this Divya Yuga is joined here, and one Divya Yuga is 4. 71 Divya Yugas is 1 manvantara. That's called 1 manvantara period. So there are Manus who will be ruling. So 1 manvantara period of time is 71 Divya Yugas. That is 71 Divya Yugas is 1 manvantara. Like that, 14 manvantaras you have to do. 14 manvantaras will become day of Brahma plus 15 sandhyas. So you can consider like 14 manvantaras. That is like a huge period again. That is one day of Brahma. 432 billion years. So, and like that, night also. One day, one night. That is the constitution of one day of Brahma and one night of Brahma. Like that, he lives for 100 years. And that is equivalent to 4 trillion years. That is 36,000 kalpas, the days of Brahma, and an equal number of nights. Days and also nights you have to calculate. That's the understanding of this. So kalpa means a day of Brahma. So that involves 14 manvantaras. So which we discussed, 14 manvantaras equal to 71 Divya Yugas. One Divya Yuga is Satyayuga, Treta Yuga, Dwapara Yuga, Kali Yuga. So if you see this, Lord explains so nicely in 8th chapter, I think, in Bhagavad Gita. Sahasra Yuga Paryantam, in that verse so nicely explains. From there we have taken and we just kept. Prabhupada also nicely explains in the purport about this. So that's the duration, it relatively grows up. So our life is nothing but very short to Brahma, and Brahma's life is very short to Vishnu. So like that it goes on. So we are currently in Kali Yuga. So, and every Yuga, as I explained, there is a certain period of time. Very important point to understand here. As there is a certain point of time in every Yuga, there is a kind of perfection which they have to do to perfect their life in that every Yuga. Satyayuga, what is the perfection of life explained is meditation. They meditate on the super soul. So for many years, and they get perfected because they have very long, lifetime is more. And Treta Yuga, they used to do yajna, sacrifices. They would do all kind of sacrifices. Ashwamedha yajna, Gomedha yajna. There are many important sacrifices which they do as a part of Treta Yuga, which will help us them to make purified. That will become their perfection of life. Whether yajnas, what sacrifice they're performing for Lord Vishnu. And then next, Dwapara Yuga. Dwapara Yuga is place where the people have lifespan of 1,000 years, and they used to do opulent temple worship, like construct different kinds of temples, and they worship the Lord there. And by that, they're getting perfection. So in Kali Yuga, we cannot do all these three. Our lifetime is very short. So we cannot do meditation for long time on super soul. And if you do meditation, you'll tend to sleep. You just sit for some time and close your eyes, we'll go to sleep. So, and then mind gets so many thoughts distorted, and we cannot do kind of sacrifices because we are not so pure to chant the mantras. We are not pure to have proper paraphernalia for performing sacrifice, pure ghee, all these things we need to have. And we don't perform kind of opulent temple worship, which we are not able to do because of having the proper standards set in the temple, following the standards. So that is also there. So we, as a lifespan is less, we, when Kali Yuga especially, it is prescribed for all of us is chanting the holy names of Lord. The Lord said, I'll be there in holy names, my holy names, and by chanting my holy names, you'll get perfected. So there is no time, place, circumstance for it. Wherever you are, whenever you are, you can chant the holy names of Lord. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So Lord explains that it's a part of Kali Yuga. That's why we are very important. We have to understand that we are in Kali Yuga, and we have seen Kali Yuga now, how it is progressing. It will progress. We have to very carefully take the importance of perfection of life, which is provided here, which is the chanting, as I explained in the scriptures, and we have to take it up, process very seriously. Sorry. Let's answer the poll too. And also hope all of you are asking questions in chat. Our Sankarshan Thayapuro will definitely help all of you. Roji is there. So Roji will reply all our answers. So the question is this. I don't know how many of you are attentive. We are currently in Kali Yuga, the perfection of life by chanting holy names. Please answer the poll. Somebody said no also. Okay. Two people. Please read the question. We are currently in Kali Yuga, right? And what is the perfection of life? Okay, not sure also. Yeah, but I would like to thank all of you for polling, and you have given almost like most of you are agreeing. Yeah, so hope you understood it. Yeah, thank you so much. Let's proceed as a, as we are proceeding about time, understanding aspect of time. We all know that how time causes deterioration. Like as the time progresses, we could see that everything is getting deteriorated. Our body will become so wrinkled as we grow old, and we can see slowly, slowly the body keeps changing. So we get deteriorated, and finally we be buried or we'll be burnt into ashes, the whole body what we are. Similarly, we see tree also, leaves, fruits, we'll see them slowly, 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 they deteriorate as the time passes. So that means we understand that there is no eternal life here. As time passes, everything will go on. It's, everything is temporary. So it's ashashvatam. So when we try to make impermanent things permanent, we cause ourselves to suffer. So we think that we permanently live here, and we have, and we permanently we're going to be staying earth in this home for a long time. So many of all assets what we have. So we think in that format, and if there is something in disturbance to that life, we feel we become so angry. So we understand that this place is temporary, and we should be ready to tolerate the things what we are facing here. And that's why Krishna explains that matra spashasta kaunteya. We have to be very tolerant. So what are we facing here? Because it keeps changing. It's not permanent, and it is temporary. The material world is temporary. And we should not get ourselves attached to these things, what we are. So we should understand that this world is temporary, and we should understand our what we have to, as a role, what we're supposed to do. Do our best, leave the rest to Lord. That will make us not to suffer. So like that, as the time progresses, we utilize our time very nicely, and we progress in our life. So next, we also know that we want to know about future, correct? We know past has given us this life, and very well, when most of us are interested, what will happen to me in future? What are the planets telling about me or my life? So if a person is really empowered by a Lord, empowered by Lord, or is a proper devotee of the Lord, and he has proper intentions, he can easily understand by going through astrology in deep study and empowerment, he can easily enter, and he can clearly predict the our horoscope and how the planets are influencing us as per our previous karma. But yeah, we know that that will be, if you have done a lot of karma, which is activities which are not supposed to be done, we'll definitely suffer. If you know that activities, it's like it's kind of horoscope for us, correct? You're going to suffer here, you're going to suffer there, and this will happen to you, that will happen to you. So we'll keep on knowing, we'll be like that. And that's like an awakening to us, if you properly know. But really, as we saw how there is one... I think Proji might have taken about the drama of Valmiki, where, and also similarly like Valmiki, there is one more hunter called Mrugari. So Mrugari was a hunter who was killing all the animals half dead, and he was enjoying his life. I mean, enjoying by seeing them suffering. That was his kind of daily work also, because he was sustaining on those. So by selling them, by skins and other things. But Mrugari is such a cruel hunter. What happened? Narada Muni showed him the future, what will happen by doing this all kind of activities. He showed him the hell, how he is going to suffer. Immediately he got awakened. So this much I'm going to suffer. Oh my God, I don't want to do these activities. So he got awakened. Like that, we get awakened, like exactly what we are going to do. And we take it very seriously, what we're supposed to do. Example, this story so nicely explains that the four letters sent by Yamaraj. Very nice story, very short. I'll explain it very nicely, that understanding of how we are given hints. So there is one person, Amrita. He actually did a lot of penance and austerity and prayed to Yamaraj. So and Yamaraj appeared and asked him, Yamaraj, you have to give me boon, that you have to indicate me before I die. Until unless you indicate me when I'm supposed to die, I will not, you have to give me boon, that you should not take me back. So like that, he asked a boon to Yamaraj. He told, okay, tatastu, okay, I'll give you this boon. So so then what happened? He knows that Yamaraj has to send him that letters. Then only, or four letters he said sending, then only he'll get death. Otherwise he'll not get death. What he did, he was keep on enjoying his life in different ways, breaking all the related principles. So everything, like meat eating, intoxication, gambling, he was doing everything. So because he was telling, till the Yamaraj tells me, indicates me through letters, I will not die. Slowly one day what happened, he could see that his hair went grey, turned grey. Then he asked his wife, he asked what happened. Just its color change of hair, nothing much, don't worry about it. Then again, after a few days, what happened? Amrita had lost most of his teeth after a few years. And the devotees came again, warning that there's a sign of losing, that is old age nearing. And then slowly, he didn't understand that also. And then again, he lost his eyesight. He could not see nicely. It's becoming dimmer. And then after a few days, what happened? Amrita was becoming more and more old, with back bent, and was suffering a stroke and become paralyzed also. So, but still, he was thinking, Yamaraj anyhow didn't send, I'll be living. I don't care. I will be living, I think, still more. So, but Yamaraj came after that. Yamaraj told that, Amrita, you spent all your life in sense gratification and sense intelligence with no interest in spiritual life. How then could you know the letters I sent you? Not one, but four letters I did send to you, but you ignored all of them. It tells that these are the signs which you can easily indicate that these are the letters which Yamaraj sent us. Even for us also, we can easily see like how slowly we come towards the death and we don't recognize it. But those are the letters which we all should understand, and we should very, very taking it very seriously, this practice of Bhagavad Gita, what we are discussing every day. And we should carefully put our steps towards it. So whatever we are doing now, we should carefully understand what God is saying and put as a practice in our life. It's very important. So by that, we get slowly, slowly purified. We did not go to Yamaraj. We'll go back directly to Supreme Personality of Godhead. So, and also this is a nice verse in Bhagavad Gita, which tells that don't think that death is only for normal people. That is there for everyone. Great kings, great scientists, great philosophers, whoever come to this world, they have to die. Krishna explains in Bhagavad Gita, 2nd chapter, 12th verse, Natvayevaham jatunasham natvam neme janadipa nachayvana bhavishyamaha sarve vayam atah param. So he's saying, never was there a time when I did not exist, nor you, nor all these kings, nor in future all shall any one of us cease to be. So like understanding that not only for us, everyone, the death comes. So, and also as a soul, for us, eternal life is there. For all of us, eternal life is there. It's not that it's like temporary, you know, we are taking birth and we are taking and dying. But actually, we are, there is no kind of, as a soul, we have eternal life there. So, and whoever comes to this material world, understanding of that is we have to take birth and we have to die. There is a death for all of us. So, and Lord also says that among all kinds of killers, time is the ultimate, because time kills everything. So time kills everything, whatever you're seeing. So time is limited. Should evolve our intelligence, our consciousness, purify ourselves, make the life joyful, should take shelter of Bhagavad Gita. So the utilized time in devotional service of Supreme Lord. So we are all fortunate that we have coming into the touch with Bhagavad Gita, understanding of Bhagavad Gita. So like time is very limited. So we understood that how the time span goes very fast. So like I started work in Monday, I'll see like it will be like again Friday night. So not Thursday, tomorrow is Friday. So quickly it goes off. Time is very fast. not wait for anyone. We utilize it very nicely, especially reading the scriptures, understanding scriptures, and practicing life. So, and the very important is a purification process. The process which I told, which I have to put in practice after reading Bhagavad Gita, is chanting the Harinam, Hare Krishna Mahamantra. Always make endeavor to study the scriptures and understand them. So books are the basis. Like, we understand more deeper about the books, what Lord has given us so nicely explaining in Bhagavad Gita, Srimad Bhagavatam, about us, about Lord, about his devotees, how should lead our life, what we have to do when we are in this world, performing our action, what to eat, what not to eat, what to do, what not to do, what to do charity, how to do charity. So everything in detail Lord explains. So what is the best way of worshipping him? So he explains everything in Shastras. And also worshipping Tulasi Devi. So Tulasi, we all know like how sacred the plant is. Tulasi is the devotee of the Lord. And when you worship Tulasi, it is like there's the prayer. Yani kani chapapani brahmahatyadi kani cha tani tani pranashanti pradakshina pade pade. By circumambulating Tulasi Maharani and watering Tulasi. So just 4 drops of water you water Tulasi Maharani every day. It takes just very little time. By worshipping Tulasi Maharani, by praying Tulasi Maharani, watering Tulasi Maharani, circumambulating Tulasi Maharani, we'll get the mercy of Tulasi Maharani. So we advance in our bhakti. So she'll be pleased, and she's the most dearest devotee of the Lord. So by doing this activity, we'll definitely purify ourselves. It is said that verse, that Yani Kani Chapa Pani, Brahma Hatyadi Kani Cha. Even the act of killing Brahmana, that must sin also will be taken away when you worship Tulasi Maharani very sincerely. And association is very important. Association of devotees, like one should also read and hear Bhagavad Gita, Srimad Bhagavatam, association of devotees. So when you read an association of devotees, we'll get more and more relations. We get more and more understanding of what Lord is saying. We will understand more. So when we do that, it will purify us. It will purify our understanding. It will purify our existence. And prasadam, finally. Prasadam, we offer the boga to Lord and we honor it as a prasadam, which will purify our existence. And holy rivers. So we can pray to all the rivers. Holy rivers like Ganga, Yamuna, Saraswati. Taking deep in the rivers will purify us. Even by new year, we can chant those names of the rivers and we'll get purified by chanting the names of the rivers. So these are the activities which are recommended in scriptures about our purification. We all asked how to get purified. These are the activities, what our actions we have done, we'll get purified and we gradually becomes pure. There is no lust, there is no anger, there is no greed, there is no illusion, there is no pride. So we slowly progress in our devotional life, and one day, as Prabhupada explained, we'll become pure devotee of Lord by these practices. So there's one more poll. Can you please answer, Proji? Except we can put the poll. Yeah. Sankarshita is answering so nicely in chat, I think. What this poll is about, utilize the human form of life in engaging in purificated devotional process and get perfected. So maybe yes, no, enjoy the life to extent. Thank you so much for your answers. I think maybe. Okay. So most of you already answered. I think yes. So thank you so much for your answer. Let's so now let's chant for 3 minutes. As we understood the importance of chanting, we should chant for 3 minutes now. Let's chant. I'll repeat this mantra. You can repeat the Panchatattva mantra, which you recite before chanting the Hare Krishna Mahamantra, which really helps us to take the blessings from all of them, all the acharyas, parampara, and then we start our holy name, which will help us to focus more. And if you do any mistakes also, they will nullify us. So let's chant this. Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya, Prabhu Nityananda, Shri Advaita Gadadhara, Srivasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda. So what I'll do, I'll play Prabhupada's chanting. You all can be muted only, but you chant along with Prabhupada. 2 things you have to keep in mind. Please focus on what you are hearing. So every word of Mahamantra which you are chanting, you should hear very, very attentively. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Whatever you speak, you should hear. Hearing is very important. And second thing, when you can close your eyes, instead of seeing here and there, you can focus on hearing, and you can remember the picture of Lord Krishna, Radha Rani, you can remember them while you are chanting. Okay, let's start.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare,
Hare Krishna. Thank you for chanting. I hope all of you feel that when you close your eyes and then you focus on hearing, you can really feel that experience of chanting. So there is one activity for all of us, the interactive thing. So after this very interesting thing, that is, we're going to have a quiz session. So I'll be sharing around 20 questions. Like, you have to put the answer in chat, or if you want to speak, you can speak. But you can put answer in chat, most likely. If you are not, then you can speak if you're not able to chat. So that's one thing. Before going to that, I just want to have an interactive session with all of you, understanding yours, like around 8-10. So I just quickly, I will go through for 5 minutes, understanding of these things. Like, who is God? Like, if you want to put answer in chat, if you want to answer, you can raise your hand. You're able to hear me now? Yeah. I think some answers are coming. Krishna, who is God? Krishna, amazing answer.
Sir?
Any other answer? Yeah.
God is the person who is the creator of this whole world and he controls everything.
Amazing. What is your name?
Nanika.
Nanika, yes. Angel. Right? Yeah, thank you so much. Amazing answer. He's the creator who is maintaining us and who is controlling us. And also amazing answers here. So he's Purushottama, he's Krishna, he's Supreme Personality of Godhead, six opulences.
Prabhuji, he's Bhagavan.
He's Bhagavan. He's full of all opulences. So Krishna is Ishvara. So amazing answers. All of you understood the essence. Yeah, Supreme Godhead. Yes. Yes. Thank you so much.
Brahmaji, the creator also, you know, he's glorifying him.
Yes. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna. Thank you. Thank you so much. Next question. You all understood who is God. Then what is our identity? What is my identity? Next thing. Next question. You can put answer in your chat. Yeah. Mata, you already said Geet, Atma. Our identity is Satchitananda. Okay. What are the more answers?
We are soul.
We are soul. Very nice. We are soul. Girish Prabhu said super soul. No. Super soul is Paramatma. We are Atma. So super soul is Vibhu. We are Anu. Very short. We are Atma. We are Jivatma. We... Who is God? God is Ishvara. What is my identity? We are Jiva. We are part and parcel of the Lord. We are Jivatma. So we are Jivatma. Lord is Paramatma. Yes. Thank you so much, Prabhu. Ravi Prabhu, what is Vibhu? Yeah. So thank you so much for your answers. Identity is Jivatma. Mamata, Mamata Mataji, Anusha Mataji. It's the God through the soul. Yeah. We can understand that soul is part and parcel of God. And soul is like by quality, same by the Lord, but quantity not same by Lord. So minute in quality, minute in quantity, but quality wise same. So soul is part and parcel of Lord. Yes. Yeah. Thank you, Mataji. Yeah.
Prabhuji, can we say we are the eternal servant of the Lord also?
Yes. Yes. The eternal servant of the Lord. We keep on serving here for so many things. We keep serving the family, keep serving nation. We keep serving different community. We keep serving so many things here in our life. So basically, why? Because tendency of soul is to do service. That is our eternal constitutional position, to do service. Instead of doing the real service, we do other services here. Because service is, what is it? We are diverting so many things. So we, if you don't have anyone, even we serve a dog, we keep a dog in home and we keep taking care of dog. Like that, we want to serve someone because the nature of the soul is to serve the Supreme Lord. That's why we are eternal servant of the Lord. So that is a very nice understanding. We are eternal servant of the Lord. Yes, right. Can we be eternally happy? Third question. We devotee of God. Yes, we will be eternally happy.
We can be eternally happy if we follow the way and we serve Lord.
Yes, amazing. Thank you, Madhu. Yes. In the name of the Lord.
Guruji, by chanting prayers and worshipping Him a lot.
Yes.
And be a true devotee.
Hari Bol, Jai. What is your name?
Taman.
Taman. Thank you so much. Amazing answer, right. So, yes, devotional service, bhakti, is saving by doing chanting. Yes, we will be eternally happy by doing the devotional activities in this life also and next life also. So, not that we in this life we will suffer. No, in this life also we will be happy by chanting, by doing the activities.
By following ABCD.
ABCD, yes, amazing. Thank you, Mataji. Association, books, chanting, and diet. And then reading.
Yeah. By following Akarma, Prabhuji.
Akarma, yes. Yes. All of you giving technical answers and very nice what we discussed. Thank you. Thank you so much. Yes. Yeah. Yeah, we'll be happy by eating. Rai Prabhu is saying, yeah, we'll be happy by eating prasadam. So we'll like to eat again and again. Yeah, following for it. Yes. Why bad things happen to good people? Their karma. Yes.
Because of karma.
Because of the karma, yes. But now we have clarity. Like if we see a person is suffering, then we actually understand that he is a good people, but why bad things happening to him? Because of our previous karma, which we will not able to know in detail, but that's because of our previous karma we suffer. Mm. Yes. Most of you understood already, yes. So how should we purify ourselves? The most of, yeah.
In the devotion of God.
Yeah, by devotion of purify. Some activities we discussed just before this slide.
We should do meditation and we should always sing kirtan and bhajans, and we should also that one, we should not put meat to God, and we must not eat onion and garlic, and we must always be the devotee of Lord.
You gave almost all the thing what we discussed. Thank you so much. I think you put all everything, like we discussed about Tulasi worship, chanting, as you explained so nicely, chanting, reading books, taking dip in holy rivers. So the association of pure devotees of Lord, honoring prasadam every day, like so many.
And Prabhuji chanting Hare Krishna
mantra. Yes, it will purify us. So thank you for wonderful answers. I think most of the answers are also so nicely explained, ABCD. And also explained about, you explained the technical terms, Sanchit Karma, Prarabdha Karma. So nice, all of you got the crux. You are wonderful. All of you are using technical terms, technical words. So, so nice that all of you are very nicely understanding this Bhagavad Gita simplified course. This is, they are talking about the five themes, Jiva, Ishvara, Prakriti, Kala, and Karma. So with that, almost like we are at 8:17 now. So wonderful interactive session. I like all of you answering so nicely. I'm very happy. So, and also I hope all of you enjoyed the session. There is one more interesting thing now. You will feel like whatever we discussed these six sessions, there is one nice PPT which you are going to show now, where you're going to answer one question. You can put in the chat answer your answers. So I'll start the session now. It'll like wrap it. It'll be like 5 seconds for one question. Okay.
Yeah, Prabhuji, before that, can we have an announcement that tomorrow we'll have a felicitation function?
Yes, please. Please go first. Yeah.
Yeah. Tomorrow will be felicitation function where we are giving certificates online and future programs. How you, if you are interested, how to connect with us, and all the details will be given tomorrow. Please don't miss a tomorrow class. Tomorrow, not a class, but it is a felicitation function. Don't miss. It is very interesting, and you will get for the future journey with yours or with ISKCON. All the details will be given tomorrow. So if you quickly, if you all have on your camera, we'll take a snapshot. If you don't mind, so that will be very helpful for us. Is it okay if you can have just quickly on your camera? Hare Krishna. Then we go to quiz.
Yeah. As Prabhuji said, please don't miss tomorrow. Very, very important thing. So you will get your get to know what will be your certification details, and you'll get to know next programs. So please don't miss tomorrow our program. And we'll be meeting on guest also. So please don't miss. And as Prabhuji said, can you please open our camera so that Prabhuji can take one snap? All of us attending this Bhagavad Gita simplified session.
Stop sharing and
I stop sharing.
Is it time is
same 7 to 8:30 only. Correct, Prabhuji? Akshay Prabhu?
Yes, Prabhuji. Same time.
I stop sharing, Prabhuji. Now you can see the you can take the picker. And who are all participated, who are all registered for session, everyone will get certificate. So
thank you Prabhuji and Mataji.
Okay. Hare Krishna. You taken, Prabhuji?
Yes, Prabhuji.
Okay, well, thank you. Can I start now, Prabhuji, that quiz?
Yes, Prabhuji. Yes, Prabhuji.
Okay. I'll share again. Actually, one video was there I missed to show about Vedic rest time for meditation. Let's go with quiz, because already in the one second.
I will share if it depends on the board.
No, actually, I downloaded it. Kept ready also. Click on project. It came. You're able to see, no?
Yes.
Is my screen visible?
Yes, Prabhuji.
Okay, thank you, Prabhuji. So let's see now. We are going to recollect all six sessions. So it will be very nice that all of you participate in this, and you'll get to know a glimpse like what all we discussed. Okay, I'm starting now. So quiz time starts. First question. Bhagavad Gita has dash chapters and dash verses. So maybe you can, Prabhuji, Sankarshita Prabhu or Akshay Prabhu, any one of them can see in chat whether they're chatting the answers. They're giving the answers in chat. So we'll give, like, we can see, keep up 5 seconds or something like that. we'll go to the next one.
Answer.
Yes, again, answers. Okay. Okay, very nice. This is the first session we heard about it, right? First slide we discussed about this Bhagavad-Gita has how many chapters?
Correct answer, Bhagavad-Gita.
Okay. Correct answer is B. There are total 18 chapters and 700 verses are there. Okay. Now, second question. What are the five topics of Bhagavad-Gita we discussed in this Bhagavad-Gita simplified course? What are the five topics? Let's see. Put your answers in chat.
Ishvara, Jibha, Prakriti, Shara.
Someone is asking something.
No. Are,
okay. Okay. I hope all of you answered. So let's see the answers. Ishvara, controller, Jiva, ourself, Prakriti, nature, material nature, Kala is the time, and Karma is our action. So five topics of Bhagavad-Gita we discussed. Next, go to third one. As a driver drives a car, dash drives the body. Who drives the body?
Soul.
Yeah, right. Soul. I'll give the answer. Correct answer is soul. So very simple and straightforward. What is this Gigo principle?
Sir, it's garbage in and garbage out.
Okay. Some people said A. Some people said
B. Both A and B.
Okay,
both
so
A and B.
Yeah, correct. A and B is the answer. So both A and B is the answer because we put garbage in, garbage only will come out. If you put good in, good things will come out. We should be good, correct? No, we should cultivate good values, good character. So we should cultivate all good things. Then only we can speak the good things. So that's why both A and B. Very good. Next. The picture tells about...
Guru Parampara.
Yeah. Thank you so much. I think you all understood. Tells about the Guru Parampara. See, from the Lord, it comes down in the disciplic succession. And from Acharya, Guru, we learn all this. So that's why authentic, what are we reading? Bhagavad Gita as it is. Nice. Thank you. Match the following. Who is Bhagavan?
Bhagavan.
Having all six.
Ascending
all
six
Brahman. Who is Brahman?
Brahman.
Brahman presents in
Present in everyone's heart.
Yeah, thank you, Mataji. All of you very nicely answered. Bhagavan is having full opulences. Brahman means present everywhere.
Paramatma in everyone's heart.
Yeah.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Next question. Okay. How many bona fide sampradayas are there?
Bona fide.
Four.
Five, Prabhuji.
Four.
Somebody told five also.
Four.
Okay.
Four.
Varnashrama Dharma is four.
Varnashrama Dharma is not the sampradaya. Sampradaya means?
Three.
Four, five.
Which is the correct answer?
Four.
Yeah, it is four. Four is the right answer.
Four, Prabhu.
We have Brahma Madhva Gaudu Vaishnava Parampara. You can see Brahma.
Gaudiya Parampara, Sri Sampradaya, Madhva.
Kumara Sampradaya.
Rudra Sampradaya, correct.
Four Parampara. Four Sampradayas are there. Very bona fide.
Correct.
Nice.
Yeah.
What did Arjuna ask Krishna for? What did Arjuna
himself?
Krishna himself.
Battlefield.
Krishna himself.
Yeah. You should also ask Krishna.
Yeah.
Correct. Krishna. So all are very, very nice. All of you doing very fast, very quick. Who is the cause of all causes?
Krishna.
B.
D. You're saying so much. D.
B.
Only B.
Krishna.
Krishna. Sir.
Yeah, we saw that verse in Brahma Samhita that Ishvara, Parama Krishna, Satchita,
Adi, Govinda,
Sarva, Karana. All causes, Krishna. Nice. Answer is B. Next, Paritranaya Sadhunam, Vinasaya
Chaitam,
Dharma Samstapanataya, Sambhavami, Yuge. Point out the odd statement.
Protects the devotees.
Four.
Point out the odd statement. Odd
one. Does appear only once.
Yeah. Most of you already answered. Like, see, this verse, no. You have to point out the odd one because Paritranaya Sadhana means who protects the devotees. Vinashaya is Duskrutam. Duskrutam means who are
annihilate
like annihilate demons. So Dharma Samstapanatha means
Dharma.
And Sambhavami Yuge Yuge.
Again and again.
But this is odd, no? Lord comes only once. No, Lord comes again and again.
Again and again.
Yeah. Every Yuga he comes again and again.
Satatam.
Yeah. Many incarnations are there. Yeah.
Yeah.
Next verse. Karmanya Vadikaraste Mafaleshu Kadachana. Ma karma fala heturbur mate sangosto karmani. What does the above sloka tell us?
You have right to fruits of action without performing the action.
Fruits of action without performing the action.
Okay. How many of you say B can raise your hand? Prabhuji will see.
B. Correct.
Because we have the right to perform our act. Karma neva adhikaraste. We have to. But ma phalesu kadachana. So whatever we have to do our action, but the results of activity should be. So we are not entitled to our fruits. Fruits should be given to Lord. So we have to do our duty, our best. And results, yes, Lord will take care. We should not more bother about the results.
Yeah.
So do our action very nicely and we should leave it. Lord will take care of the rest.
Yeah.
So, identify the character appearing on the left side. So, maybe
Supanaka. Supanaka.
Supanaka.
Supanaka.
Supanaka.
B.
Supanaka.
B.
This is also B.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Rama and Lakshmana.
Yeah. ABCD of purification process. What does
chanting.
C
mean? Chanting.
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 Chanting. Chanting.
B.
Chanting.
B.
B. Next question. Match the following. This you have to do carefully. Match the following. We learnt this karma, karma, right?
Karma performing the action. Akarma.
Akarma, yeah.
Akarma means
all the
activities which should not cause
activities
against
the nature of one. Activities does not cause karmic reaction.
Vikarma is illegal activities against the law of
men.
Karma is
Sanchita karma means all the karma we have acquired from all the previous lives.
Previous.
Yeah, Sanchita karma too.
Prarabdha karma means
the pains and gains a person has to endure in the life present.
Present life.
Present life.
Okay.
So almost all of you answered rightly. All of you answered. I think you all understood the answer very nicely.
Yeah, yeah.
So karma means performing the acts. Akarma means activities
which do not cause karmic reactions.
Karma means
current class.
Illegal activities against.
Illegal activities against in the laws of nature.
And D, Sanchita means accumulated from previous lives. All the
yes.
Part of the karma means this life.
All the pains and gains.
Prabhuji was saying that this class is also akarma. We're discussing about Bhagavad Gita. So, nice. Discussing. Who was Valmiki in his previous life?
Ratnakara.
Ratnakara was previous life. Thank you. Name two methods of purification.
Cloth purification.
By chanting. By chanting.
Chanting Hare Krishna and Prasada and doing
Hajjan. Being an associate.
ABCD is very easy to remember also. No? Association, books, chanting and prasadam.
That's what we learned from you.
Prabhuji?
That's what we learned from you during the class.
Yes, sir. Yeah.
I wrote down that's written that only we have to.
14 lokas C.
How many loka planets are there in the middle world?
14.
14 lokas.
14.
14.
14.
Not 10.
No.
14. What is Adhya
Bhutta means?
Adhyatmika is caused by body and mind.
Other living being.
Yeah, also we asked, like, hear your voices.
How Adhibhautika is misery is caused by other living beings.
Yeah, let's
Adhibhautika is misery is caused by other living
beings. Yeah. Adhibhautika
Adhidaivika misery is caused by power of time, nature, and demigod.
Misery is caused by other living beings.
Yeah.
Adhyatmika means Atma means ourself because of
ourself. Body and mind.
Daiva means other demigods, nature,
demigods.
Adhibhautika means other living beings.
Other living beings.
Very nice. All of your answers so nicely. So next, Lord Vishnu represents which mode?
Mode of goodness.
Sudha Sadvik.
None of the above.
None of the above.
No, actually, what you can say is he represents mode of goodness because
mode of goodness.
Yeah, in the description of modes we discussed, right? Every Trimurti Gunavatar, they represents that mode. They are not in that mode, but they represent mode. And they take charge of that mode in living entities. Like Lord Vishnu represents that mode because it has to be in that mode because he has to maintain this whole universe. It's a huge task. And Lord Vishnu is in mode of, he's in charge of mode of goodness. Mode of ignorance means you have to annihilate, destroy. That is Shiva. Mode of passion means you have to create. You have to create something means you need passion. That is Brahma.
Mode of ignorance is for Lord Shiva and mode of passion is for Brahma. And mode of goodness is Vishnu.
Yeah, they are representing, they are not in that mode that we have to keep in. They are like a supreme being where they are representing that. So Sutta Sattva means where you are like going to even from Lord Krishna comes all these expansions. We understand that Sutta Sattva means we are going to the transcendental mode where complete pure goodness, that is devotion, the transcendental
beyond mode. All three modes.
Yeah.
Yes. Nirguna.
Yeah. What a good answer. All living beings are
Satchitananda.
That means
eternal.
Ananda means knowledge.
Yeah. Thank you everyone for actively participating in this.
Thank you, Prabhuji.
Oh. Thank you, Prabhuji. It was
for giving this opportunity. Nice session. Yeah.
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji.
Hare Krishna.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Prabhuji. Let us thank all for arranging the session from our temple. All who all participated, who all arranging the session. We'd like to thank all of them. And let me open. So today, Q&A question answers, Prabhuji. I'll just stop sharing. Maybe Akshay Prabhu. And,
Prabhuji, tomorrow also do attend because of what is the future plan we have to know and certificate, online certificate and so many things are there tomorrow. So requesting all devotee to attend tomorrow session.
Same. Yeah.
Same time. Prabhuji, next class, next what program you have to announce tomorrow, Prabhuji?
Conducting advanced courses, Prabhuji. So tomorrow at what time you should present?
Tomorrow 7 to 8:30 same time, we have courses already lined up. One is next course is about Bhagavad Gita Advanced. The course title is Bhagavad Gita Advanced. So that is the next course. We'll go more in detail tomorrow. Tomorrow they'll explain us and there will be certification ceremony and you will hear from a guest speaker and you will get to know many things. So tomorrow please attend. Don't miss the session. So it's our request from our side. And,
are you conducting the sessions daily or weekly once?
Yeah, we'll discuss in tomorrow's session.
Okay.
And that is out now from announcement side. We'll take up question answers now for today's session about time and what we discussed about time. So you have any questions, anything? Prabhuji, already someone raised hand. Ganesh Prabhu raised hand. Go ahead, Ganesh Prabhu. Sankarshita Prabhu, myself, Akshay Prabhu, all are there. Like we will do our best.
Can I ask Prabhuji or somebody is asking? I can ask.
No, Ganesh Prabhu, you can go ahead, Prabhu.
Prabhuji, I wanted to ask what is the best time for reading Bhagavad Gita and chanting both?
Is there any particular time, like, and whether we require to take bath before chanting or we can directly get up and chant? Three questions. Sorry, Prabhu.
Yeah, no problem, Prabhuji. Very, very wonderful questions. Very real questions. Very practical what you asked. So there is no kind of any rules and regulations. I'm answering the last one. There is no kind of any rules and regulations. You can chant without taking bath also. No problem. You have to chant. You can chant. You can read the book without taking bath also. No problem. You can take the book and you can read. So there's no problem. Because in Kali Yuga, we don't know. We already.
भगवत गीता कितने छोटे छोटे पिल्ला ने सुन चुके बढ़िया एटलीस्ट जीवन का कौन वाली जानी आ रही है माया
हमारे स्पीकिंग हाँ
हाँ
यू कैन म्यूट देम प्रोजी आई एम जस्ट ट्राइंग टू
आंसर पिल्ला सुन चुके
हैं पंडित
जैसे वो लोग किसी ज्ञान धर्म किसी नाइ खाली खाई हो तक
मुझे स्पीकिंग बंगाल आई थिंक कैन वी कैन म्यूट देम आई विल ट्राई टू आंसर प्रोजी क्वेश्चन सो Prabhuji, as you said, I heard from many seniors and even scriptures say about it. There is no time, place, circumstance. There is no kind of anything you want to take bath. You should not chant. No, you can chant. Slowly, we'll understand it. But there is no hard and fast rule anywhere in scriptures mentioned that without taking bath, you should not chant. No, you can chant anytime, anywhere, any place. You can chant Hare Krishna Mahamantra. And also reading Bhagavad Gita, you ask, without taking bath also you can read. You can get up and you can chant. So that is one thing, very clear. And especially we told Brahma Muhurta is something significant because we all see that is a time where you can focus more. That time, as I told, your mind will be peaceful. There are no thoughts. You can focus more on hearing the mantra and the activity you do daytime and nighttime. Like it will take a lot of time to complete. But if you do in the morning, it will be very quick and you will be very active. So that's why if you chant in the morning, if you read in the morning, it will be like impressed in your mind for many, many years to go. That's why if you see people recite slokas, mantras in the morning because they can easily remember them. So that's how, Prabhuji. Is it all your questions answered, Prabhuji?
While doing work also we can chant.
Thank you. Yes.
Hare Krishna. Yes, Mataji.
While doing work also, when we are cooking or doing some work, we can chant the mantra. No?
Yes, yes. While cooking you can chant Maha Mantra. Like for example, you are doing an activity which you'll need not that much focus on your work. For example, if you're working in an office, laptop or something, you have to focus on our work. Yeah, we have to do our work. Like when you are like free kind of cooking, or you are doing something, garden making for Lord, altar cleaning, or cleaning our house, so washing vessels, you can play one lecture, nice kirtan, as Prabhuji played today. You can keep a short lecture or kirtan, aram se can hear the kirtan. There are so many dramas. Whatever we are seeing is, we are have to move our kind of whatever lifestyle we have, we can move easily from to spiritual things. It will very help us.
Thank you, Prabhu.
I would like to say one thing.
Yes, bro.
Krishan from Bombay.
Yes, bro. Yes.
Whenever bad thoughts comes on your mind, you say Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Rama. That thoughts will go away. That is my practical experience.
Hare Bol. So as Prabhuji said, Krishan Prabhu, yeah, I think, yeah.
Or we can say this is the best medicine for removing our bad thoughts.
Yes, Prabhuji, yeah. Thank you, Ro. Thank you for your relations. Hare Krishna. Yes, Taman, you're asking her?
Yes.
Sir, tomorrow at what time will that certificate class be?
As of now, we decided same time only. If there's any change, Prabhuji will update in WhatsApp group. As of now, 7 to 8:30, same timings. Okay. Someone raised hand. Amar Prabhu.
I have one question, Prabhuji.
Yes, Prabhu.
It is relating, connecting karma and your kala. We see some of the child who died in premature birth itself. So how the kala works there?
No, your question is like premature baby in the sense just taken birth and passed away, like that you are saying?
Yes.
So how that falling might affect? Actually, we discussed the Prabhuji, Prarabdha Karma, Sanchit Karma. So Prarabdha Karma is accumulated from so many lifetimes. So many lifetimes, autumn accumulated. In that, some portion is given to us. Sanchit Karma is accumulated from so many lifetimes. From that, some portion is Prarabdha Karma. There will be some other karma which is already there. Like for this lifetime, you have to just you have to suffer for 9 months in a womb, and immediately we have to die. Again, next time we have to take birth again. So getting, no, next package of Prarada Karma will come to you in next life.
Prabhuji, I have a doubt, Prabhuji.
Okay.
Where does the soul locate? Like the super soul god?
In the region of heart, we discussed that in the how in a tree, two birds are sitting. One bird is super soul, another bird is soul. So we are soul, and super soul is Paramatma. Just next to us is sitting in the heart. We are soul, we are in the heart, actually. Beside us,
Prabhuji, what I meant was, where does Bhagwan live?
Not only in your heart, near the region of heart.
Okay.
So there is a verse in Bhagavad Gita, no? Sarvasya Chaham Hridi Sanni Vishto. He is saying the region of Hridi. Hridi means heart. 15th chapter.
Yeah.
Hare Krishna. Any other questions? Today open for questions. You have any questions, you can ask, or Sankarshita Prabhu, myself, Akshay Prabhu, there. Please, you can ask questions today.
Prabhuji, we get to know that there are, if you do wrong karma and wrong illicit work, we'll go to the naraka, right?
Yes.
When we die, our only soul, there won't be any body, right? Only soul will go. How the treatment been given to a soul? We don't have a body.
Very nice question, wonderful question. So however we go there, they'll give us a particular body to us there to suffer. When you enter the planet there, we'll get a body where we will suffer in that body. So they'll give us a body there.
Thanks, Prabhuji.
Hare Krishna. You'll feel that pain when you are going hell, when you are suffering. So we'll because that is our kind of punishment given to us because of our actions.
Thanks, Prabhuji.
Hare Krishna. So, Sankarshita Prabhu, all the questions in chat answered, Prabhuji. Almost like, I saw you replying.
Yeah, yes, Prabhuji. I think almost all are covered. Yeah.
Thank you so much, Sankarshita Prabhu.
Yeah, Hare Krishna. Thank you, Prabhu.
Any other questions from anyone?
One question I have, it's so much of karma in the background. How can we go to another level? We will definitely be taking one more birth and we'll undergo all the miseries, and we have to clear our karma. Then only we go to another level. So how can the soul get another level?
Very nice question, Mataji. So very wonderful, thoughtful question. Like, if you are in karma, like, we keep on suffering there, so we will not go into the next level of understanding God and move into it. So that's why we could see the process what Prabhupada has given, and devotees are very merciful. Okay. They are trying to approach people to tell them, they go nook and corner saying that, giving them prasadam, first prasadam, giving them prasadam, understanding that importance of Lord, and then telling them the importance. Like, we have to reach to many people as much as possible. Now we all have learnt. It's our responsibility to teach who are all we know. So okay. We can keep giving to others this knowledge, importance of Bhagavad Gita, and telling that we try to inculcate in them so nicely, telling the important points, practical way of implementing it in our life, so that we feel peaceful, we be happy in our life. So we can do that. We can reach out to many people as much as possible. Now we all heard these sessions. Most of you are here. You can tell your friends there are like these sessions happening. You can also join. You can invite your friends to these sessions. So like that, what will happen? You are going to reach many people who are not lost in this material world. Like, they are like completely, they are thinking life is earning money, living happily in a family with a lot of comfort zones. So like all of us, me including all of us, we are in that zone because of mercy of pure devotees, mercy of people. They are spreading this message. See, now our temple devotees, they come together. They decided we'll go ahead as a nice offering to Prabhupada. We'll go ahead and talk to devotees and spread this message. And then I request all of you to go ahead. You also can spread this message. Take more people and just inform them. If they're interested, they can join. If not, fine. So like, we can do our action of at least doing that. We are going to reach many, many people like that.
Thank you, Prabhu.
Yes. Voice is breaking.
Hare Krishna. Oh, sorry.
Yeah. Yes, Prabhu. Yeah. Yes, bro. Yes, go ahead, bro. Yes, I can hear you.
Prabhuji, I wanted to ask the 700 shlokas, how many days it will take, Prabhuji, this advanced course?
Prabhuji, I think weekly course it is. In detail, tomorrow we'll get to know, Prabhuji. I also want to discuss Prabhuji's now. So, but it will be like, mostly we want to go in detail, like how we are going to have it weekly once or twice or how we are going to plan.
Keep it after 7:30, Prabhuji, means India time, after 7:30, better, 8 o'clock like that, if possible.
Sure,
Prabhuji. It's my suggestion.
Okay. You are from which place, Prabhuji? You are joining from which place?
I am Abu Dhabi, so, you know, but after 7:30 means here it is 6 o'clock, then I can join, you know, it is possible.
Okay, Prabhuji, okay, Prabhuji. Sure, Prabhuji. I understood, Prabhuji, that 7:30 means for you it will be easy to join, so
yeah,
it's too early. Yes. Okay.
Yes.
I'll discuss with them, Prabhuji. I'll talk to them. Hare Krishna.
At the end of this Kali Yuga, there will be dissolutions universe, Prabhu, material world.
Prabhuji, that dissolution, there are two types of dissolutions are there. One dissolution is, we have seen the lifetime of Brahma, no? In that one day, one night is there. So the day Brahma will be there, the night Brahma goes to sleep. That time half dissolution will happen. So from Brahma down, all the planets will go in water, like down planets will go in water. So we are under the water for that is partial dissolution. There is complete dissolution where Brahma dies. That is 100 years of Brahma completed. There are two types of dissolutions are there. So after Kali Yuga, it will not end. So Satyuga, Treta Yuga, Dwapara Yuga, Kali Yuga, one Divya Yuga. Like that, how many 71 Divya Yugas? One mantra. So 71 into 14, that becomes one day of Brahma. So one day of Brahma, then after the day, there is similarly one night, the day equal to night, 12, how we calculate here. If Brahma goes to sleep, that time dissolution will happen, partial dissolution will happen. And complete, when Brahma goes to sleep, that is, when Brahma passes away, that is 100 years, then that time full dissolution will happen. All the things will go into Mahavishnu, from whom everything is coming.
Prabhuji, I have one question. What will be the last moment of Kali Yuga? How it will be, Prabhuji?
You can read Srimad Bhagavatam, Prabhuji, 12th canto. So they nicely explained. I'll just give like whatever I read in brief. So 12th canto, Srimad Bhagavatam explains that Kali Yuga people will be like, if you ask some, in Kali Yuga after, if the age passed, if you ask anyone, what is your age? Then my age is 20. It will be 20 years will you die, like that you will tell. So it will become like that. And some, they'll become short. They'll be very short in size. And they'll be like a lot of quarrel fight. And like there are so many other things like explained by so nicely that it's so degraded that people do all illicit activities and people are hypocritic and they keep quarreling. So there are so many other descriptions are there in Kali Yuga, especially in the 12th canto of Srimad Bhagavatam. But that's what it gets degraded. So much degraded that people try to eat other human beings also. So that will go so deep.
Prabhu, I have one question. They say intuition is God. Is it true?
I didn't get your question.
Intuition is God. So is it true?
Intuition. Exact meaning, Mataji. Maybe Sangashita Prabhu want to answer?
No, in the sense, sometimes your mind or your inner thing says not to do it. But we'll just go ahead and do it. Yeah. So that intuition is called God. Somebody.
Yeah, Mataji.
They say it is.
What we hear that is like almost right only, Mataji. How it is because that inner voice comes from Paramatma. Example, I told that if you don't have any bad habits, like someone comes and tell you do this activity, then immediately what you will feel like you will not do it. And when you start doing that activity because of bad association, you will feel something like in the heart saying you should not do it, but you are doing. You'll get that voice hearing from the Lord. So okay, Paramatma there in the heart, he will guide us actually. If you are very interested in spiritual life, he will give all the things favorable for us to proceed in our devotional life. Similarly, he will try to protect us also. So if you are putting, like now we don't even care that Paramatma is there, we keep on doing our activity. But if you still do some steps from our side to putting towards Lord, like now we are all doing, understanding more about Lord doing, like we put some steps towards Lord, Lord will do more and more informing us that you should do this, you should do that. So you will get more and more, can hear from the Lord.
So that inner voice, we should not neglect.
not neglect. Yes.
We should. Okay, yeah. Okay. Yeah. So with this so much of Krishna consciousness, pure mind, pure conscious, clear, can we make out that when this pandemic will end?
No, that's what Mataji. That's Lord's, Lord's karma, that's which we, Lord's plan is very unable to predict. We're not sure. What are there in our hands is, not only we're saying like inner voice saying that maybe next month Corona ends, or no, I'm saying that inner voice is something which we all easily observe it and perceive it. But to understand exactly what super soul guiding us, we need spiritual master. We need a guru in our life to guide us. Because we whimsically will tell that my inner voice is saying eat this, go to movie. We'll do spirituality also, but we'll do this also. I'll keep like in my both the boats. So like that, we tend to tell ourselves that I can do both. That will be like kind of mix up. So we need a person who is already practicing for many years, very mature. So that person should guide us very nicely in our spiritual life. You can tell him, reveal him, because you have trust in him that this person is very confidential. He tells something, he will not tell to anyone. And he is kind of person who is already practicing for so many years. And he is very stable in his life. So we'll go and reveal to him that this is what I'm feeling. What do you say? So then they will tell us, they'll guide us so nicely as per scriptures, their experience. And we'll slowly take steps towards accordingly. So that's how we should practice, Mataji. What I understood from my seniors and whatever I'm.
Okay, thank you.
Alex.
Prabhuji, we have mosquitoes, cockroach, or rodents. So sometimes they are troubling us so much that there is no other way. We have to drive them away or keep some medicine or anything. Does that add karma to you? Like, it is inevitable. We have to. Yeah, so what should we do in this case?
Yeah, but action, there will be reaction. So.
But they're troubling, no? So.
Yeah. We generally tend to do it. There is no option.
We try to avoid it, but if there is no other option, in that case, what will be like?
So, we do an action, definitely will get a reaction. So I heard that one devotee is saying that in his home there is that honey, honey generally they keep that full hive. So it kept in his home only. So what Proji will do now? So he has to make it start throwing it away. So otherwise, if it comes also, it will attack us. So what option? He has to leave in house, right? So we chant Hare Krishna, and then we kept the fire, and then all the honey bees went away. Like that, as a part of life, we tend to see we should not harm the other creatures, but if you harm, we will get a reaction. That is something which we have to pray to Lord, and generally what we practice, we chant Hare Krishna. So we chant Hare Krishna for them, and we chant loudly. So that's what whatever I heard and what we are doing. Maybe Sankarshita Prabhu or Akshay Prabhu, you want to add, you can add for this question, Project.
Because we have to save our lives, no, Prabhu.
Yeah. Otherwise, we'll be having that tension or anxiety in our life, that this thing happening, that the cockroaches are doing this, rats are doing like that. So we tend to have it. So that's what I was trying to say, that we have to chant Hare Krishna loudly to them.
Okay. So,
Thank you, Prabhuji.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji. Is this the starting of Kali Yuga? Is this starting of Kali Yuga or middle?
No, just started. Just 5,000 years. So we have 4,32,000 years. We completed 5,000 years. Now 4,27,000 years are there still.
Okay. Thank you, Prabhuji.
So yes, Hare Krishna.
Because some people every now and then they keep saying 999, it'll end, 222, it'll end, something they'll come up with.
2017, movies also there. So, no, they're like Chinese calendar, this is the date ended. So, we are going to end on that day. But scriptures clearly predict, and scriptures clearly say that what is Satyuga, Treta Yuga, Dwapar Yuga, Kali Yuga. Whatever we see in scriptures, we are seeing also nowadays around us. Scriptures predicted, those things are happening. So it will happen. There is no way scriptures prediction goes wrong. So it will be always same.
Okay.
There is some question.
Prabhuji, there are four varnas. Brahmana, Shudra, Kshatriya, and Vaishya.
Yes, Prabhuji.
Will these, whatever I understood or whatever I perceived, I heard that by birth, some may say that your father is Brahmana and automatically you become Brahmin. So is that correct, or it is based on the work they are doing, whether it is relevant in today's scenario? Because I work in an IT sector, so I earn, I do my work. Some I may be a Brahmin birth boy. I mean, how we I can relate this, whether it is relevant in this world or all are same, or how I'm confused in this.
Very nice, Praji, thoughtful question you asked, and you thinking about it. Very nice. We all have these questions. Even I too had this. Whenever Krishna tells that in Bhagavad Gita, fourth chapter, Chaturvidha Bhajante Mam, what is that verse? Chaturvarna Maya System, Gunakarna Vibhagasa. Chaturvarna Ashrama. So there are four Varna and four Ashramas are there. So Krishna so nicely given this society to have these divisions. According to their nature, they have to work. According to nature, they have to take certain shelter in an ashram. So as I said, there are kind of four varnas are there, like Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya, and Sudra. So Krishna also gave this division that according to their nature, they have to, they will be like Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Sudra. So in current context, as I said, like it is explained, Kalo Sudra Sambhava. Scriptures say in Kali Yuga, most of us who have taken birth are Sudras only. Although we have taken birth in Brahmana family, they're considered to be Sudra. Because in Kali Yuga, the person can be called as a Brahmana only by his qualities and characteristics, which he is having in him. Scriptures say that he has to have this Karunya, Titiksha, Arjava, Saucham. So there are 26 very nice qualities which should perform as a Brahmana. We should read scriptures, should explain scriptures to others. Kshatriya means who do administration. Take kind of management and administrative services, protection of other people. Vaishya means who does agriculture, taking care of cow, and do business. Shudra means one who serve all other three people in the other order. So what we are doing as a part, I am also part of IT only. I work for HP and now I am working at HCL. So we work for under some person, right? We are Shudras. We are not Brahmanas. We are Shudras. Plus working under some other people. It's really true, right? So, actual Brahmana means, I told you, right? That's how we should be. Like, we should learn scriptures, read scriptures, and should lead our life to explain this knowledge to others. So, even in the IT company, we see this division happening because there is a person called CEO, correct? Who is the person? That person using his brain to take all the decisions and do activity. But in the same company, there is something called administrative services, which is the taker of only administration in IT company only. And there is something called people who are Vaishyas, who do business, who do sales, go out and do talk to many people and do the business. And there are people who they're in office, they do cleaning bathrooms, cleaning toilets, cleaning the places, serving here and there. You can see like overall, like working, right? The main person who, the one is CEO, like the division, you can see like how they divided according to our qualities, our nature, how they divided. So similarly, Lord has created this universe. If you have this kind of Varnashrama Dharma, having Lord in the center, with all these people having different nature as per their inclination, then it will be very peaceful. So, but as you said, we are in the current society where if you are working and we are serving other people, like in this way of that is kind of, we are kind of Sudra level only. We can ourselves, what we have to do is, we are doing, as of now, we know that's what we are doing as a part of our action. Whatever we do an action, we get a result, right? That we have to offer to Lord. So we do a job, we get some income from out of it. Some portion of it we'll offer to Lord as a service. Our whole whatever we're doing action will get purified. So that's how we have to do Praji. And we can cultivate the qualities of all this, as I explained about Brahmana or Vaishya, especially Brahmana, because we understand the importance of scriptures, learning scriptures, and we do it. And people who are having that tendency, they'll do it. And they also should be engaged in service. Some people are having tendency of doing administration. They also will engage in different kinds of administration services in related devotion. Like they have to go to take permissions, talk to people. So big people, so we'll use them. We'll do the service there. And some people want to do kind of Vaishya, like doing the business kind of, like how to have the proper understanding of engaging those aspects of business in devotion. And then we have Is it clear, Prabhu, or confused?
Clear now.
Okay. You're able to hear me, no?
Yeah.
Prabhuji.
Hare Krishna. Mataji is saying one question, Anisha Mataji. I had a dream of Lord Shiva 3 years back. I thought it was a dream, but today I saw it in reality in the same way. And the name of the place, Hare Krishna. So Mataji, Anisha Mataji, your question is that you were never knew, but you got some dream about Lord Shiva, and Lord Shiva came to your dream. So I'll say, but not the name of the, you never heard the name, and you know, visited also. Fine, Mataji. It's good that you're getting good dreams about lords and lord devotees. So Shiva is, as per Srimad Bhagavatam, it says Vaishnavanam Yatha Shambho. Topmost Vaishnava is Lord Shiva. So maybe that place exists or not, you can already have come to the process of understanding Bhagavad Gita, which tells about importance of Lord Krishna. Like Shiva is a devotee of Lord Rama and Lord Krishna only. So Lord is coming in dream telling you that he gave you a recitation in the dream. So you are getting opportunity to hear all these things. That's my understanding. Just understanding I'm telling. But you can take that as a most fortunate, because Lord coming in your dream and telling you. So you should also become like Lord Shiva, like in his footsteps, becoming good devotee of Lord. So how Lord Shiva taught Parvati about the holy name of Lord Ram, and Lord Shiva want to take darshan of Lord Krishna, he came to Vrindavan. So he stayed there for a long time to take darshan. So like that, we all can become Mataji in that footsteps of Lord Shiva. So we can practice so nicely, can please Lord Shiva who is coming in your dream. Hare Krishna. Any other questions? Yeah, I hope all are also leaving. It's already late, but actually we want to take more questions. What all you have? Because today is last.
Thank you, Prabhuji. Thank you, Prabhuji.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Prabhu.
Hare Krishna. If you are getting, you all getting late, who have questions, they can stay back. If you are getting late, we can drop off. Maybe that will be good. Hare Krishna. Akshay Prabhu, any other questions, sir?
No, Prabhu. I think Sankar Prabhu
already answered. I think
he replied.
Okay. Maybe you have to previous sessions start. We'll discuss. Maybe we can see if any questions are missing. We can take up.
Yes, Prabhu. But devotees will be there. Then it will be more benefited. Or yeah. Those devotees are here, they can ask if they have pressing questions in mind.
Yeah, Prabhu. Yeah. I think there are no questions, Prabhuji.
Oh, Prabhuji, I have one question, Prabhuji.
Yes, Prabhuji.
I heard some videos and other YouTube channels that all the universe is based on our thoughts, that law of attraction and all. Is it the same what we are telling, that whatever we do the karma and what will so we'll get it? Is the same analogy used as what we think, what we become? And all the universe is going through the process of thoughts. So if I am thinking I want to be rich, or I want to buy a car, I'm thinking of the same thing for 24/7, I'll get that, the law of attraction. Is the same thing what we are referring as karma here?
Whatever Prabhuji said, it's like you keep on contemplating one thing. For example, I heard that one incident where one person was keep on contemplating on going to US, want to be in US and you want to be like that. What he did, GRE exams, no? GRE exam, what he has tried. There is a book called Barons. Keep the open book and he keep thinking about US only. Like he dressed like US dress. He talked like US people, doing like this. So he was completely meditating on that thought day and night, even dreaming, talking, wearing dresses, missing music, doing hey like that. So I heard that like what will happen is that person is doing this and contemplating so much about those activities. Next life, he'll take birth in US. Not like human being, like dog only. he'll become dog there. Because he didn't do any activity, right, related to devotion. Just led his life thinking about it. And even in this life, because of so much in dream, what he did, he could not even crack GRE. Because he was so much contemplating about US. So like that, it will happen. What we have to do is, we can contemplate, we can desire for things which are make us close to Lord. Like now we are contemplating on more about exactly understanding who am I, why am I suffering here? Because other things, anyhow, it is destined. Like happiness, distress will come and go in our life. But we have to understand, like, why you have to suffer and why, what is the goal of life? Why am I here in this material world? So we keep thinking, and when you think, Lord understands that we are inquisitive and we get an opportunity to learn more, we take up the process of which make us come close to Lord. So like chanting. So as I said, now what made him to become like that? Same desire. Now we have a desire, that same desire, that I want to become a devotee of Lord. I want to understand more and about what is his creation, how it is created. So nicely explained Srimad Bhagavatam, like first creation, second creation, and then annihilation, how it is, how the baby in the womb develops. So on all predictions, all devotees' life, so much depth is there. You can read so much of novel. You need not go to YouTube. You can take Srimad Bhagavatam book, you start reading the book, you will get to know so many things. Like you will see what is there in the book outside as it is happening. Like you can really perceive it. Like as I said, not creation. Creation, you can understand in deep what creation is. You can understand in deep about more of science, biology, explained about how the living entity in the womb. And also you'll see different kinds of devotees, their lifestyles, how they led their life, and in depth. Like you will see like how they have taken their life and they have become, then they have shown it. Like we have human form of life. We have to get perfected and we have to reach our destination. So either we can more and more, we can understand.
Thanks, Prabhuji.
Thanks. Right. Your good name, Prabhuji?
Girish Prabhuji.
Girish. But very nice question. So yes, Prabhuji. Thank you.
Krishna. So if there is no question, tomorrow we'll meet again.
Yeah.
At 7 p.m. I will share Zoom link, same Zoom link, and I will tell the details in the WhatsApp group.
Yeah, that's better. Yes.
Hare Krishna. I think having one question put in chat box morning, I was sharing with you. We will definitely share Vijay Prabhu. Hare Krishna.
Oh, Vijay Prabhu will share. Actually, I spoke to Koshin Gopinath Prabhu. We'll update him. Yes.
Yes. Hare Krishna, Vijay Prabhu. Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you, all the devotees. So we'll meet again tomorrow.
Hare Krishna. Thank you so much.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
I'm ending the meeting now. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.